Hello, I'm Angela Lam, and I'm the author of 5 romance novels, a short story collection, and a memoir. Today, I'll be reading from my latest romance, Friends First, published by the Wild Rose Press. And this is a parallel romance. What I love about romance is the happily ever after ending and the fact that the heroine has to be someone who's strong and relies upon herself to solve her problems. She isn't rescued. That's the whole thing about romance. It's not being rescued by the guy. Or as Julia Roberts said in Pretty Woman, if she is rescued, she rescues him right back. So today I'll be reading from the beginning of the book. And this is the book is told in alternating points of view between Maddie and Greg. And again, I said this is a parallel romance. So we're going to begin with Maddie. All I want to do is drink alcohol and eat meat. Maddie gripped the pen tighter as she wrote in her diary, unleashing the pent-up frustration she wished she could confide in a friend. I've gained another 20 pounds since the engagement. And Darren wants to know what's wrong. He calls me Porky. When I told Jane, she said he was only teasing. But when I told Peter, he said I'd better lose the weight quickly and for good. No yo-yoing. Peter is right because the night before Darren left for his latest business trip, he said if I gain any more weight, then he won't find me attractive, and the wedding will be off. I've always wanted to get married, so I don't understand why I can't lose the weight. Maddie broke off writing, grabbed a bottle of beer, and guzzled without tasting the bittersweet hops. She plunked the empty bottle against the kitchen table of the Emery Point luxury apartment in Atlanta, Georgia, she shared with Darren, who would be returning home in 2 days, 3 hours, and 47 minutes. Early afternoon spring sunlight filtered through the white lace curtains, but the powerful brightness could not expunge the darkness within her. In the background, an infomercial played in the living room. The soothing sounds of a man and a woman convincing viewers to purchase a weight loss supplement lulled Maddie into the illusion of being in a house full of people. Maddie hated being alone, even for a few moments, ever since she was 6 years old and woke up from an after-dinner nap all alone in a dark house while her parents and siblings shopped at a last-minute sale. Sometimes she didn't understand why she ended up with Darren, who often traveled 2 weeks out of every month for a sales job. Wiping her mouth with the back of her hand, she picked up her pen and wrote, I haven't had sex in 3 weeks. Maybe he doesn't find me attractive anymore since I haven't lost weight. She took another swallow of beer and continued writing. If only I could stop drinking, maybe I could stop eating, and then maybe I could lose some weight. Setting down her pen, she grabbed a handful of salty potato chips and shoved them into her mouth. The crispy crunch grinding between her teeth overpowered the nagging thoughts she just confessed in her diary. Ignoring the pang of guilt squeezing her chest, she walked across the tile floor, opened the refrigerator, popped off the top of another bottle of beer, and took a long swig. A catchy tune played on her cell phone. She wiped her hands on her jeans and punched accept. Hello? It's me, Darren said. I'm at the airport. My last sales calls were canceled. I'm coming home. Gasping, she swiveled. Beers and chips littered the kitchen table. A pen nestled between the pages of an unfinished diary entry. Thundering heartbeats galloped in her chest. How much time did she have to clean? How soon is your flight? I thought you'd be more excited than you sound. I am, she groaned. I'm just tired of being alone. What have you been doing all weekend? She gripped the phone tighter. Heat flamed her face. Oh, I'm so ashamed. I can't tell him the truth. Drinking beer, eating junk food, and writing complaints in my diary. She shifted from foot to foot. Hurry, think of something else to say. She forced a smile. I've been catching up with my sister. Did you shop for a wedding dress? I never shop with Jane. Anger stiffened her back. Although she loved her little sister, she also hated her for being thin and wealthy. Whenever she stood beside Jane, frumpiness and poverty invaded her. I can't afford the shops in Buckhead. You only buy a wedding dress once. She laughed. How could he promise to be married forever when he threatened to cancel the wedding as she became too fat? Wasn't love supposed to be unconditional? Well, I've got to go. He heaved a sigh. They're boarding the plane. See you in 3 hours. Maybe we can go for a walk. Okay, Porky? Irritation bristled across her shoulders. She hated that nickname, but she didn't have the courage to tell him. Sure, she took another sip of bitter beer and slumped against the wall. Love you. Love you more. After the call ended, she finished her second beer and seized her diary off the kitchen table. She curled into the sofa and scribbled, I hate him. I love him. I hate him. I love him. If you want to read the rest of it, again, it's Friends First, and you can find it at your local library.